this out.
Good evening.
Ocean Drive's films on Thursday with Eclipse Dine-In Cinemas Bundoran. Now serving pizza, hot dogs, ice cream and more to your seat. Find out more at Eclipse Cinema.
It's that time of the week, folks. Time to join our man at the movies, Collie McFadden, live from Eclipse Cinemas in Bundoran this afternoon on Zoom. Very good afternoon to you, Collie.
Hello from a cold and frosty Bundoran. I say frosty. It's starting to rain. This morning was the first morning I got up to go to college early this morning. Ice in the car, and you just go, oh, yeah.
Oh, here it comes.
It's that, it's that time, isn't it? You know, just
there's nothing you can do. I know. You know what would be good? Nice warm cinnamon.
Well,
have we a few movies?
I've got plenty of movies this week. So if you remember last week, because Wakanda Forever, which of course has done gangbusters, was out, everyone was staying away. And this is one of the weeks. It's an interesting week because there's lots of smaller movies. We've actually six different movies and a couple of classics coming out. We're probably only going to cover five of them. So look, we've so many. We should start with the first one. We're going to talk about The Menu. This is a new black comedy starring Ralph Fiennes. Do you know what? We'll have a listen and see what you think.
Good evening. Welcome to Hawthorne. It'll be our pleasure to feed you.
Tonight will be magical.
Over the next few hours, you will ingest fat, salt, protein, and at times entire ecosystems.
We're eating the ocean.
We're eating the ocean.
Are you crying?
It's just I find it all very moving.
So it's okay that I'm not as into this as you are? Oh my God.
You shouldn't be here tonight. You, my dear guests, are not the common man. Isn't that right? Yes, sir!
Is he gonna keep doing that?
What happens inside this room is meaningless compared to what happens outside. Yes, sir! We are but a frightened nanosecond. Yes, sir! Nature is timeless. Yes,
sir! What the hell is going on? Yes, sir!
I love you all.
We love you too, Chef!
Oh, yes. There's something sinister about this feel.
Absolutely.
I'm not talking indigestion.
No, definitely not. Although I just had a thought. I think that's how you should start the show tomorrow. Good evening. I am going to entertain you with music. This was a funny one because I put this on last night because we had a quiet screen. So I snuck in. I don't forget to watch things at nighttime anymore. But I snuck in last night, put this on. I was kind of tired. I was kind of half watching it. And the start, I'm going, think to myself, these are the most annoying people in the world. I like my food. Anyone who looked at me would know I like my food. And I've evolved over the years from being what's that foreign stuff? To really liking going out to dinner and trying new stuff. But it was all the worst people in the world that you could be sitting beside a restaurant. The way they're talking about the food, the snobbiness. And I was going, I don't know if I'm going to be able to sit through this, Seamie. And then I realized, this is the point. They are the worst people in the world. He has purposely invited the worst people in the world to this restaurant. Whoa. And the one difference is, the character played by Anna Taylor-Joy, who loads of people probably know best from The Queen's Gambit, She is a last minute replacement, so she knows there's something strange going on. So, but I'm watching it going, okay, this is a bit intriguing, but I'm still only half watching. And then something happens, and I went, oh my God, I was not expecting that. And the whole movie changes. So this is a movie that's got, actually it's got a bit in common with our Missed It Monday, Don't Worry Darling, and is it starts off as one movie and becomes another. And I think, like that movie, a bit like Banshees of Inisherin too as well, you could have two people walking out, one person going, what in God's name is that about? And the other person going, oh, I love that. Oh, I love that. That was clever and it's weird and it's sarcastic. And it's a satire, I suppose. But I don't want to start using the sort of language about this movie, which I know sometimes I do, that these people use about food and you go, oh my God, just eat it. You want to hit them over the head with a lobster. But it's really interesting. Ralph Fiennes is great. He's clearly enjoying himself as the chef. And he does this clapping announcement before each meal. Oh, it's so annoying. But it's really odd and weird, and it's very funny in a dark, dark way. And they're kind of
looks great.
Oh, it looks so beautiful. And I don't think food has ever been photographed so nicely, even though, you know, people like myself and yourself, Seamie, might go, that looks nice. Where's the rest of it? Where's the rest? The portions, my God. They serve the portions on a big rock, and you're going, yeah, but you couldn't eat that, could you? Really interesting, really fun. Won't be for everyone. For everyone. But I thought it was really enjoyable. And a big surprise. One of two big surprises this week.
Okay. It's not on the scary front, though, really.
It's on the scary front. A little gory, maybe, at times.
Gory, that'd be the word.
Fucking is gory, you know?
And there's nothing wrong with gory. Our next one, Confess Fletch.
Yes. So, here's another one that I found frustrating, but for a very different reason. So, some of us that are old enough will... do you know when you say they don't make movies like this anymore? This is one of those, right? When I was a child, a long time ago, there were loads of movies with wisecracking detectives or investigators. They'd always be solving a crime, but always had a one-liner for it. And one of those was the Fletch series starring Chevy Chase. He made two movies. I really loved them when I was a young fella, but there was always loads of... I think the phrase they used to use was gumshoe. Gumshoe detective movies, right? So now we've got the very handsome John Hamm, who people know from Mad Men and loads of movies. They bring it back because apparently there was like 14 books. And I was watching that. I'm just out of it, out of the cinema at 5 o'clock after watching this. And I was a bit frustrated because I was going, this is really good. This is really good. And it's only got a kind of limited release. It's only on a few times in all the cinemas. And it's only going to be around for a little while and it'll probably go off to a streaming service on. And it deserves to be seen because it's really funny. But because it doesn't have a mega star, or it's not so much a roar out laughing as smiling all the way through and going, oh yeah, very good. Oh, that's funny. And everyone's really, really enjoying themselves making this movie. John Hamm is so good at this. He's so funny. He's all these running jokes about Uber drivers and all that sort of stuff. And it's a silly detective show. And people who like Carl Hiaasen books, who, you know, wrote Striptease and those sort of stuff, that sort of sarcastic investigative reporter with it, and there's always a point to the story. I really enjoy this, and I just don't think enough people are going to go and see it. And such a pity, because these sort of movies, it's a grown-up fun movie. I really enjoyed it, and I hope people will go and see it.
I come here, is it set in Rome or something, or is it...
It starts off set in Rome. They're all these Italians, and it's all about an art heist. That, you know, only happen in the movies. You know, an art heist, but then most of it's set in Boston. And of course, the character of Fletch is famously an LA Lakers fan, and he's wearing his LA Lakers hat in Boston, which is not popular. Very enjoyable. Really enjoyed it.
Okay, right.
This stupid idiot moron has something to do with this.
You want me on the outside so I can solve this thing.
Are you Fletcher?
Yes, I am.
Oh!
I mean, no, I'm not. I always get that wrong.
I don't know what people hate more. Cops or reporters?
It's cops.
Speaking of blockbusters,
we've got a Christmas movie, have we?
Well, we've got two, right?
Oh, have you?
The most famous story at this stage when it comes to plays and musicals and films has to be A Christmas Carol. Has to be Charles Dickens' Christmas Carol, including the best one, which I couldn't get into the cinema, although I think it's brilliant, A Muppet's Christmas Carol. But there's so many versions of this story, from Scrooge to, you know, to the classic Christmas Carol, to the Jim Carrey one. So we've got two versions of it today. Or, sorry, opening up tomorrow. First of all, we've got Spirited, which is one where it's Will Ferrell and Ryan Reynolds are playing it. And it's kind of a modern-day Scrooge. It doesn't mention Scrooge, but it's kind of wink, wink, nod, nod. So Ryan Reynolds, playing against type, is this horrible person, because he's always a funny, charming guy. And anybody who's watching Welcome to Wrexham will have seen that. He is a charming guy. But in this way, he's obnoxious. And Will Ferrell is kind of the ghost of Christmas past, coming back to haunt him. And it's a big song and dance, shiny, very American, very saccharine musical. But I think people, you know, I like Christmas movies, but I don't love Christmas movies. But I'm always amazed how many people just hoover them up. Just love it. And if you like big jazz hands and sprinkles, and I would imagine everyone's going to hug each other in the end, that sort of thing. This looks really fun. And two
spent
very
a fortune on it. 75 million, folks.
Yeah, it's
does it look like it?
made by Apple. Well, certainly from the trailer, it does. Although I'd say the two boys got a lot of the 75 million. It's all Hollywood showbiz schmozzle. Funnily enough, probably everything that Charles Dickens would be against, because he, seen as he campaigned against poverty. Tiny Tim. This would have fed Tiny Tim for a long time. Speaking of which, there's also a cartoon version of the classic tale called Scrooge, A Christmas Carol. So this one would be for maybe the under 12s. And the other one would be for over 12s. And it's a classic story in beautiful animation. I've only seen about 10 minutes of this as I was getting the film ready for the cinema, but it looks lovely already. I know there's lots of schools interested in booking this one already because it's such a classic story. Nothing says Christmas like Scrooge, so we've got that too.
Come here, I see Gremlins on our list.
Oh, yeah, Gremlins.
One of my favourite movies.
Which people wouldn't always think of straight away as a Christmas story, but it is
a Christmas story.
It's set at Christmas, and there's a real dark story, if you remember, his girlfriend about Christmas and her dad. But Gremlins are back, and it's funny how many, like Ghostbusters, the younger generation all know Ghostbusters before the reboot, but somehow Gremlins seems to have missed them and delighted to have it back. And we already got loads of emails from parents saying, when is it on? I want to bring my kids. Now, I'm pretty sure when I saw Gremlins first time around, it was 15s because it was continued too scary. Whereas now it's 12A, and your most 10-year-olds are going to look at that and go, you call that scary, mister? I don't think so. Whereas we were all
scarier things in my kitchen. Yeah,
we were all terrified by it, but it's great fun. And the rules and like the cuteness.
Gremlins. Fantastic. That's on the can't go wrong with Gremlins, folks. You can't go wrong. Don't worry, darling. It's Mr. Monday.
Did very well for Harry Styles and particularly Florence Pugh. As I mentioned earlier with regard to the menu, one that divided people. And Harry Styles got a lot of grief for his performance in it. I think unfairly, because without giving away any spoilers, I think you're supposed to think he's a bit of a wobbly, dodgy character. Or certainly that's what the movie's trying to make you feel. It's a story set in the 1950s. It is maybe, if I said earlier, the menu is the best looking food movie. Don't Worry Darling might be the best looking movie this year. It looks gorgeous. You think it looks like perfect 1950s world, something goes wrong.
Okay, that is Collie on movies this week. Have a good week at the movies up there in Eclipse Cinemas. We'll talk to you back here Thursday.
See you then. Bye.